Hey mathematicians, it's Justin again. The triathletes didn't just compete in the triathlon, they trained, tracked, and prepared for months. And this year, we collected tons of data on their training habits. Now, we need your help. We're building a training guide to help future triathletes prepare. We'll need to analyze real data from this year's athletes to make informed and thoughtful recommendations. That means examining different graphs and using what we learn to solve real-world problems. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to analyze different types of graphs, like bar graphs, frequency charts, line plots, and single line graphs to uncover patterns, solve problems, and figure out what the data is really telling us. Have your guided notes ready, and let's explore these graphs together. We'll start by exploring a set of data about swim training. This first graph is a line graph that uses a single line to show changes over time. What kind of change do you think it might be showing? Take a look at how the line moves across the graph. Pay attention to the peaks, dips, and stretches where it levels off. It shows the changes in how far the athlete swam as they prepared for race day. Now, compare this line graph to the bar graph we used in our last lesson. What similarities do you notice between the two graphs? Check out the high points, low points, and changes in distance over time. It shows the exact same swim data, just in a different format. Which week had the highest swim distance? Which week had the lowest? When did training stay pretty steady? Pause here to analyze the graphs and how they tell the same data story in different ways. The highest swim distance occurred 6 weeks before the race. After that, the distance dipped, rose slightly, and dropped again in the final weeks, with the lowest distance happening the week before the race. This shows us that athletes peaked around week 6 and gradually scaled back their training to rest and recover before race day. Because this single line graph shows the same data as the bar graph, we should notice the same pattern in the bar heights, and we do. Both graphs are useful tools for identifying training trends. So, based on this data, what might we recommend for future training schedules? Our analysis suggests that athletes benefit from a mix of longer and shorter training distances, with a few lighter weeks for recovery. That way, swimmers can show up to race day strong, prepared, and well-rested. Moving on, we also have data on hydration. Athletes tracked their daily water intake, and the data is displayed here on a single-line graph to show how it changed over the week leading up to race day. Use the graph to help answer the questions we'll consider for our training guide. Which day shows the most water intake? The least? Is the trend steady, or are there jumps or dips? What might explain those patterns? Pause here to analyze the graph and record your thinking in your guided notes. You might have noticed that athletes drank the least amount of water 7 days before the race, and the most water the day before the race. The line trends steadily upward, showing that most athletes increased their water intake each day as the race day got closer. This pattern likely helped them stay hydrated and prepare their bodies for peak performance. That's an important detail for our training guide. Encourage athletes to gradually increase their water intake, especially in the final days before the race, so they're well hydrated and ready to compete. We'll continue building our training guide by investigating the total time athletes spend training each week across running, biking, and swimming. This will help us determine how many hours future athletes should commit to training for each part of their race. Here's a list of weekly training hours from a group of 40 athletes. Try grouping the data into categories: less than 5 hours, 5 to 7 hours, and over 7 hours. We'll organize this data into a frequency chart. A frequency chart is a table that lists values or categories alongside the number of times each one occurred. Pause here to sort the data into the three categories and complete the frequency chart in your guided notes. Does your frequency chart match mine? Here's the data displayed on a line plot. Each X stands for one athlete. You might notice the line plot looks similar to a bar graph, just without a vertical axis. What's the mode or most frequent training amount? Most athletes trained between 5 and 7 hours per week. That's a useful insight for our guide. Future athletes should aim to spend about 5 to 7 hours each week training across all three events. This range seems both realistic and effective based on what current athletes actually did. Now for one final factor for our guide, rest days. What does this bar graph show about how often athletes rested? Are most athletes taking rest days every day, just once a week, or somewhere in between? Based on the data, what would you recommend to future athletes? Pause here to record your analysis and recommendation in your guided notes. This bar graph shows the number of athletes who took 1, 2, 3, or more rest days each week. You might have noticed that most athletes took 1 or 2 rest days per week. Very few took 3 or more, and hardly anyone trained every single day. This suggests that athletes balance effort with recovery, training consistently, and giving their muscles time to rebuild. For our training guide, we could recommend that future triathletes plan for at least 1 rest day each week and possibly 2 during intense training periods. With this, we've now analyzed key factors for practical training: how much to swim, how much water to drink, how many hours to train, and how often to rest. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that you could discover a lot by looking closely at a graph? Well, now you know that graphs and charts aren't just for showing numbers, they're tools for solving problems. They help us make sense of real-world information by organizing data and revealing patterns we might not notice otherwise. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice solving problems using the data from different charts and graphs. And remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.